Archangel Michael, my brave ones, do not seek God in the heavens or some far away, unattainable place, for the essence of the Creator, a spark of divinity, resides within your sacred heart. Many of you are becoming aware of your divine origins, however, you have only a slight inkling of your vast potential as a bearer of cosmic love or light. It is vitally important that you become attuned to the ever-increasing frequencies of the new divine blueprint for the Aquarian age, for they will assist you in attaining the status of a self-master, which is necessary if you wish to move forward gracefully on the ascension path into the variant new world of the future. Beloved ones, when you allow the shackles of time, space and the density of the lower dimensions to fall away, your visions will become sharp and clear. Your resolve will strengthen and you will confidently move forward with ease and grace, for your constant mantra will be, for the greatest and best good of all. Remember, you should place no expectations or restrictions on how or when your visions will manifest. As more and more of your cosmic origins become available, many of you have become uncomfortable and fearful when you read some of the stories of your ancient history and the messages which describe the great diversity of creation. It is up to you to accept or discard what you will claim as your truth. We have told you that there is much truth woven within the myths and stories of your past, probably more than you would like to believe. Since the question has been asked for our messenger, allow us to give you an example. Down through the ages, humans have always had a great fascination with dragons, both good and evil, and they are one of your most enduring myths. Dragons are depicted as great beings with wings and long sweeping tails, often with colored scales of skin and always breathing fire from their mouths and nostrils. Some people have a great affinity for these creatures. However, mostly they are feared and depicted as dangerous or evil. Some years ago, when this question was posed to our messenger, we took her on an inner journey out into the galaxy so that she could experience the true origins of the dragon myth. Many, many eons ago, as this sub-universe was being seeded with its divine blueprint, envision yourself as God-conscious beings of great radiance. You were magnificent, expansive and flowing beings who contained within all of the rays, colors, virtues and attributes of the Creator. Some of you choose to display the rippling, iridescent colors of what might appear to be scales, while others experimented with many other forms. As a co-creator, sun, you soared and experimented, leaving great trails of light that could be described as wings and a sweeping tail. And as you used your powers of creation, you breathed forth great beams of God's first ray of divine will and power, or the fire of creation. Oh, what wondrous beings you are, and what wondrous deeds you wrote as you soared throughout the great void of this new unmanifested sub-universe. All of this was in preparation for your eventual descent down throughout the multi-dimensions and into the physical worlds. However, many brave souls agreed to remain in the dragon brigade in service under the great builders of form and archangels. The dragon brigade is active without this sub-universe at every level in which the programmed divine blueprint is to be made available for manifestation within the material realms of existence. Only those of you who have been able to move out of the confines of your physical vessel and soar in spirit to the higher realms have an inkling of what those wondrous realms are really like. We have told you that the visions and explanations we give you are of the most simplistic nature and are only a minuscule portion of how it truly is where we reside. So you see, in order to bring forth these wondrous visions of how it was in the beginning and the multitude of forms you have assumed, you have had to filter them throughout your physical mental faculties. The dragons and many of your monsters are only your version or vision of some God's greatest creations, and your concepts could not be further from the truth. Each and every one of you is responsible for what the energy you draw forth from the cosmic bank of primal life substance. How are you spending your spiritual inheritance as we embark on this important phase of evolution? Together, please take time to define your commitment to yourselves and to your universal spiritual family. Know that we, the angelic forces, under the direction of our father or mother, God, stand steadfastly beside you. When you sense we are near, trust your feelings, for in truth we are beaming our love or light into your auric field. Listen to the whisperings of your soul, for it will unerringly assist you in the following the best course of action and help you to make the wisest choices. You are loved most profoundly. I am Archangel Michael.